guess all of you have a smartphone or an iPhone. And this morning, probably you check on the weather. If it's going to be rainy, to carry your umbrella, it's going to be sunny, to use your sunglasses, or it's going to be cold, to have an extra coat. It can give you sometime good information and sometime not. Let me tell you, my best app is my grandmother. She's called Mama Ada. She can tell you not only today weather, but she can predict the next 12 months it's going to be a good rain season or not. She can tell you just by observing her environment, by observing the wind direction, the cloud position, the bird's migration, the size of fruits, the plant flowers. She can tell you by observing the behavior of her own cattle. That's how she knows better the weather and the ecosystem where she lives on it. I'm coming from a pastoralist community who are a cattle herders. We are nomadic. We move from one place to another one to found water and pasture. We can move up to 1,000 kilometers the size of California within 1 year. And this life helps us to live in harmony with our ecosystem. We understand each other. For us, the nature is our supermarket, where we can collect our food, our water. It's our pharmacy, where we can collect our medicinal plant. But it's our school, where we can learn better how to protect it and how it can give us back what we need. But with the climate change impact, we are experiencing a different impact. In my community, we have one of the top 5 fresh water in Africa. It's the Lake Chad. When my mother got born, Lake Chad used to be about 25,000 kilometers square of water. When I get born 30 years ago, it was 10,000 kilometers squares. And actually now, it's about 1,200 kilometers square of water. 90% of this water just evaporated, disappeared. And you have more than 40 million people living around this lake and depending on it. They are pastoralists, they are fishermen, and they are farmers. They do not depend from the end of the month's salary. They depend from the rainfall. They depend from the crops that are growing or the pasture for them cattle. The shrinking resources, you have many communities that are fighting to get access. The first come is the first serve. The second have to fight and to death. So climate change is impacting our environment, but changing our social life. Because the role of man and woman in this region is different. Man is supposed to feed his family, take care of his community. And if he cannot do that, his dignity is under threat. He cannot do anything else to pay it back. So climate change takes our minds far away from us. That is the migration. They can migrate to a big city where they can stay for 6 or 12 months, where they get a job, they can send back money. If they didn't get, they have to jump into the Mediterranean and be migrant in Europe. Some of them died there, but none of them stopped going. Of course, it's sad for the hosting country, who are developed countries, who have to adapt to host the migrant coming. But how about those who are left behind? The women and the children who have to play the role of man, the role of woman, who have to take care of the security, of the food, of the health, of the entire family, children and all the peoples. So those women, for me, they are my hero. Because they are innovators. They are solution makers. They are changing the little of the resources into the big for them community. So those are my people. So we use our indigenous people's traditional knowledge to get the better resilience to what we need to survive. Our knowledge are not only for our communities, it's to share with each and others who are living with us. And indigenous peoples around the world, saving 80% of the world biodiversity. That's the scientists who tell us. Indigenous peoples in Amazon, you can find the most diverse ecosystem, better than the national park. The indigenous peoples from the Pacific, the grandmom and the grandpa, they know where to get food after the hurricane hitting them. So the knowledge that our peoples know is helping us to survive and help other peoples also to survive with the climate change impact. World is losing. We lost already 60% of the species, and it's increasing every day. So one day, I took a scientist to my community. I said, you are giving the good weather information through the TV and radio. But how about coming to my people? And then they come. They sit around, and suddenly, as we are nomadic, we just start packing our stuff. And then they say, like, are we moving? I'm like, no, we are not moving. It's going to be rain. And then they are like, oh, there is no cloud. How do you know it's going to rain? We're like, yeah, it's going to rain. We pack our stuff. Suddenly, heavy rain starts coming. And you are seeing the scientists running around, hiding under trees, and then taking them stuff. We already packed ours. After the end of the rain, the serious discussion starts. They say, how do you know that it's going to rain? We say, well, just the old woman observe their insect taking them eggs inside them homes. And while the insect cannot talk or watch TVs, so they know how to predict to protect them generation, how to protect them food. So for us, it's the sign that it's going to rain in the maximum couple of hours. And then they say, like, well, we do have knowledge, but we do not combine ecological knowledge and weather knowledge all together. So that's how I'm started working with meteorological scientists, peoples, and my communities to give the better information to get people adapt to the climate change. I think if we put together all the knowledge system that we have, science, technology, traditional knowledge, we can give the best of us to protect our peoples, to protect our planet, to restore the ecosystem that we are losing. I did that in another way also. I use a tool that I really love a lot. It's called a 3D participatory mapping. Participatory because it can bring women, men, youth, elders, all the intergenerational peoples. Then it's used a science-based knowledge, and community come together, they build this map, they figure out all the knowledge that we have about where is our sacred forest, where is our water point, where is our corridors, where is the place that we move during each season. And these tools is amazing because it builds the capacity of women. Because in our communities, women and men cannot sit together. Men talk always women just sitting there. But in the back, they are not there to take any decision. So after the man figure out all the knowledge, we say, well, may you call the woman, come and have a look? They say, yes, sure, because they already done the first work. When the woman come, and then they look at the map, they are like, no. This is wrong. Here where I collect the medicine, here where I collect the food, here where I collect all. So we change the knowledge into the map, and we call the man. What do you think about what woman said? All of them checking their head. They are right. They are right. They are right. So that's how we build the capacity of the woman and giving them voice in this 3D participatory mapping. So women get the detailed knowledge who can help community to get adapt. And men have the bigger repair knowledge. So when we put it together, this map helped them to discuss, but to mitigate the conflict that between the communities to access the resources, to share better these resources, to restore it, and to manage it for the long term. Our knowledge are very useful. Indigenous people's knowledge are very crucial for our planet. It's crucial for all the peoples. Science knowledge are discovered 200 years ago. Technology 100 years ago. But indigenous people's knowledge is thousands of years ago. So why we cannot put all this together, combine those three knowledges, and give the better resilience to the peoples who are getting the impact of the climate change? And now it's not only the developing country, it's the developed countries also. We saw the hurricane, we saw the flood around all the places, we saw the fire, even here in California. So we need all those knowledge to come together. We need the people in the center, and we need the decision maker to change. Scientists tell them, and we tell them, and we do have those knowledge. We have 10 years to change it. 10 years is nothing. So we need to act all together, and we need to act right now. Thank you.